Be strong.
Hi friends, welcome back. If you're new here, my name is Trey Trujillo and this is my channel. Last year I made a YouTube video about how I became a go-go dancer in West Hollywood. Ever since I made that video, I've been getting so many DMs and so many messages on Twitter and Instagram of people asking me how I became a go-go dancer, tips and tricks, what they should experience, what they should be like ready for, stuff like that. So now I'm gonna make this video of 10 tips and tricks that I highly suggest that either you keep in mind or that you do that will help you succeed in becoming a go-go dancer. Let's get to it. Tip number one, become friends with your security. This is important because this is your safety. Okay, when somebody touches you inappropriately, harasses you, people get rowdy, people fight, there's a lot of stuff that goes on in clubs that just happen on a whim, and sometimes you are in harm's way. So it's very, very important for you to become familiar with your security and know them by name. In case anything pops off, you just wave them down or call them out and they can come and save you, help you out in any way you can. Very important. Tip number two, I highly suggest you go to the club and scope it out on the day that you will be performing a week or two in advance. It's very, very good to go and just scope it out and to know the scene, know the people, know what goes on, know when it gets busy, because these are all important. When you go on your sets, whether it's four sets, two sets, whatever sets you do, whatever hour rotations you do, it's important to know when it's popping off so you can wear better costumes, better outfits. Also, it's really nice to just get familiar with the clientele, know who goes there, know the scene, be prepared. Number three, this is a trick. Bring your own baby oil or coconut oil or whatever is good for your skin. So what I didn't know is that people lather themselves in oil when they dance just because it gives a nice glow, it accentuates the body, it makes you just look like you're glistening. Also, if you're gonna wear oil, bring either baby wipes or a wet cloth or something, because girl, I remember when I'd go back there on my break and try to go on my phone and that it was just slipping, sliding everywhere. It was just messy. Sometimes there's a lot of dancers who will ask to use each other's things, which is no problem. It's, you know, sharing is caring, but it's always nice just to have your own stuff because you will meet those people who do not want to share anything with you. They just don't. Also, bring extra pair of underwear, extra hats, extra costumes, whatever you think. Pack for what you think you need and then pack more, because it's better to have more than to have less. And sometimes there are rules and regulations as to what you can wear. Some clubs do not allow you to wear jock straps because it reveals too much, and there's all these rules, so it's also nice to know the rules. Ask people what you should wear, but always bring extra. Number four, this is just a very biased one. Bring snacks. Bring food, bring something to eat, because I remember when I first started dancing, I would literally starve myself because I was like, you know what, I need to look skinny, I don't need to look bloated. Do not dance hungry, do not dance thirsty, because you're just not gonna feel it. It's not gonna go well. Your body becomes exhausted because you're literally dancing up there forever. Sometimes it's really cold, sometimes it's really hot, so make sure you eat. I know a lot of the guys that I used to dance with used to bring their meal prep because we had a microwave where we used to change and stuff like that. So bring food, eat, feed your body, be healthy. Do not starve yourself because you are not gonna do yourself any favors trying to look skinny. Trust me, don't do it. Number five, this is a really big tip and I really need you to take this seriously. Do not walk out of that club alone at the end of the night, because you are putting yourself at risk. There are people who do not care about you, and there are bad people in this world. I cannot tell you how many times I have been followed to my car. I cannot tell you how many times I've had stalkers stalk me outside the club. It's not safe. Either go out the back way where you have a safe way, group up with people, ask other dancers to either drive you to your car or walk with you to your car, because too many bad things in this world happen, and I've seen them firsthand. I've literally had a car full of men, and I'm in sweatpants, a hat, and a jacket. Like, I am not, like, no skin is visible, and I still had a car full of men stop by me and be like, you were dancing, oh, let us give you a ride, get in. Get out of their car and, like, follow me. And I remember I hustled my ass back to the club and had somebody walk with me because I was not about to do all that. Also, carry pepper spray or carry something to defend yourself with in case anything hits the wall, because like I said, anything could happen and you need to make sure that you are safe because nobody else is gonna do that for you. Number six, I don't know if this applies to people in small cities. I would suggest you do it anyways. I was working West Hollywood, LA. Network. Network, network, network. Because when you are putting yourself on a stage and you are dancing, you are going to meet amazing people, talented people, famous people. You're gonna meet people. It's just bound to happen. Out of go-go dancing, I've also done modeling. I've gotten brand gigs. I've been in music videos. I've done so many things. I've met Sam Smith. I've met Patrick Starr. I've just met so many different people. I've met New York. You never know who you're gonna meet and you never know who you're gonna run into. So always just be prepared to network, get to know people, talk to people, show your personality, be yourself, like do it because you will not regret it. You will get so many side gigs. You'll probably meet other promoters of other clubs who wanna pick you up, who want you to dance at their place. You'll meet photographers. LA and West Hollywood is thriving of talented people. So put yourself out there and get to know people. It's okay to be nervous, but just make the effort to get to know people and talk to people because I promise you, it will get you farther in this industry. It just will. It's entertainment. Number seven is also very important. It's becoming friends with your clientele. And what I mean by that is that I don't mean like best friends, but get familiar with your regulars. Build a relationship with the people who come to see you every week to dance. Know people by their name. I know that is something so simplistic, but I cannot tell you how many times where I've had regulars come up to me and I remember their names and I'll be like, oh, hey, Mark, how are you? And it lights up their face. If we're gonna be realistic, they might tip you more. But it's really good just to know people and to know people by their names. I understand that some people go up there and they don't want to socialize. They don't want to get to know anybody. They're just up there to dance and be half naked and do whatever they need to do. And that's fine. You can do that all you want. I know people like that. They don't like to get personal with people. That's fine. Me, on the other hand, I'm like a dog. I like to talk to people. I like to socialize. I like to laugh with people. I like to get to know what they're doing. I've gotten on really like personable terms with people and it was just nice. You know who you're gonna get close to. You know who's just a customer. You gotta differentiate between the two, but it's nice to know people by their names and it's nice to build relationships because then you build trust, you build a clientele, you build regulars, and that's important because it's an inflow of money. They tell their friends, that's even more money for you. It's just, be a nice person, you know? It doesn't hurt just to do that. But also know your limits and set your boundaries. You are human, you have boundaries, you have limitations. Stand by them and don't let anybody tell you otherwise. Number eight is to be personable, be you. Obviously, when you first get into a club, you kind of have to limit yourself. And by that, I mean, you need to follow the guideline of the club. You wanna fit the vibe. You wanna get your foot in. You want a solid foundation as to whether like, you know what, I'm gonna keep hiring you and I'm gonna keep putting you up there because I like you and you fit the club criteria and blah, 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 blah. That's fine. Once you're in there though, test the waters a little bit, you know? Be you. When I first got into my club, we had to be very machismo. It was very much like East LA, Latino machismo. Like, they just wanted everything super masculine, and that was fine. Unfortunately, I was never allowed to wear my hair down there, but I found ways to just be me, the way that I danced. I remember when I first started dancing there, they're like, you know, kind of be stiff, don't move around too much, don't twerk, don't do all that stuff. And I was like, that's fine. Then one day I just started twerking and people loved it. And the club promoter was like, wow, people actually like that. You should keep doing that. And so it's nice just to test the boundary sometimes. There's no fault in that. At the very least, the club promoter is gonna be like, don't do that. There have been times though where one club promoter like literally tried to embarrass me out on stage or like yelled at me backstage because I was being too feminine. Whatever, it's fine. Not everything's gonna work for everybody. That's fine, but just always be you, be personable. Just, you don't have to be like everybody else. I remember I always used to compare myself to other people, and then when I realized where I was being me and danced the way that Trey wanted to dance and looked the way that Trey wanted to look, people loved that way more than just fitting the criteria of what the club made. That's all I got to say. There's a lot of tea behind that. Number 9 is to make smart decisions and be safe. When I started go-go dancing, I was only 22 years old, and a lot of people were caught off guard because a lot of my other coworkers were like in their 30s and their 40s, and that's fine. But I was very young when I got introduced to the scene, and I am proud to say that I have a really good head on my shoulders. My intuition's really strong. I know right from wrong, because being my age, it's really easy to get swept up in the city life and the entertainment life because you're making so much money, you're surrounded by drugs, and there's a lot of older people who have no problem trying to take advantage of the younger kids. I've had people give me their room keys to their hotels, their phone numbers, made empty promises. People who are like, oh, you can trust me. People who try to get me drunk. It's crazy. People will offer you drugs left and right. People will say whatever they want just to get you in bed. It is what it is. It's the life. So you need to be careful. You need to have a strong head on your shoulders and know whether or not you're making the right decisions. If you are going to meet up with people, if you are going to an after party, if you are going to do that, be smart, but also send your location to somebody. Send your location to your best friend, a friend. Do something about it, you know? Like, go out and have fun, have your experiences, do whatever you feel is right for you, but do it in the last and the most, one of the most important things I could say about go-go dancing, number 10, is to save your money. You don't have to save all of your money, but save a good amount. You're going to make tons of money. You just are. You're gonna make more money than you thought that you would make. I remember when I first started dancing, I was just like, oh, this is cute, this is fun. I'm making, you know, like extra money. Then once I started to build a clientele list and I started to get regulars, I was making more money than I thought that I would ever make in my life. And it's so weird when people ask me how much I made just because I'm really weird with money. But if I'm gonna be honest with you guys, I was averaging at about $12,000 a month. And I was on like the lower end of making money. There were people that I danced with who made way more than me. I can't even imagine how much they made in a month because it was ridiculous, like seeing all the money they would get. So I was on the lower end of the spectrum, okay? Because I only danced for a year and then COVID hit. You're gonna make tons of money. Save it. Invest it. Put it towards something that you want. And that concludes my 10 tips and tricks about go-go dancing out in West Hollywood, LA, wherever you are. If you guys have any more questions or anything at all, don't be afraid to DM me on Instagram. Don't be afraid to DM me on Twitter. Comment down on my YouTube video below. And just, I wish you guys the best. I really do. I think the thing that's gonna take you the farthest in this journey is your confidence and your personality. Because there are so many people out there who are just hot, and that's fine. And people make tons of money being hot, but be the best you. Like, nobody can be you. So if you bring something to the table that nobody else has seen before, it's gonna blow people's minds. Like, I remember when I was dancing at the Abbey and I finally let my hair down after not being able to dance with my hair at another club, and people lost their damn minds. Do what you need to do, be the best version of you, and just have fun. Have fun. Don't take it too seriously. Don't get encapsulated in it. Just do what you're supposed to do and do it freely. So I really hope this video helped you guys out. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video so people can see it, because I know a lot of people are going back to go-go dancing. Everybody always has questions. I'm more than happy to answer them. And don't forget to choose to be you, because you are amazing. Bye.